One thing that I want to point out to everyone here is that it is an incorrect comparison to compare the Bible to the Quran if we're determining centrality to the faith. Okay? What do I mean by this? Are they both books of scripture? Yes, but that's about as far as the comparison goes. The Quran is far more central to Islam than the Bible is central to Christianity. The analog here, the proper comparison, is Jesus. Jesus and the Quran are analogous in the two faiths. What do I mean by that? Well, the Quran is the closest thing that you have to the encapsulation of Allah on earth. It's the closest thing you have to the word in earth, a tangible word of God, is the Quran. It's believed that the Quran is co-eternal with Allah, just as Jesus is co-eternal with the Father. Jesus is the word of God. Also, the point that I want to make is, epistemologically speaking, when people are investigating, is Christianity true? You're not supposed to focus on the Bible. No one ever made the claim that the Bible is perfect, therefore Christianity is true. People made the claim that Jesus rose from the dead, therefore Christianity is true. Islam, not the same. Islam, it's the Quran. The Quran is perfect. The Quran is the word of God incarnate, therefore, or incarnate in a sense. Therefore, that's the proper analog. So I wanted to give you that as a background before I address your question. These two do not hold the same place epistemologically in their respective faiths. Are there places in the Bible where there are incorrect statements, scientifically speaking? It depends on what you're trying to extract from the Bible. For example, if I were to say to my friend, hey, look, I watched the sunrise this morning. It was amazing. It was beautiful. He could, if he wanted, laugh at me and say, Nabil, the sun doesn't rise. The earth revolves. You're an idiot. You're inaccurate for having said that. If he's trying to extract that degree of scientific accuracy from my statement, then you could say I was being scientifically inaccurate. But if you are trying to extract the message I'm saying, I watched, you know, as the sun came above the horizon as it was perceived by me. If you're trying to extract the message that the Bible was actually saying, what it was asserting, in that there are no errors.
Thank you.
I believe that you are a Christian if you believe that Jesus is the one God, Yahweh. He died on the cross and rose from the dead. Died for your sins, rose from the dead to prove it. That's what I think makes you a Christian. If you believe in multiple gods, you're not a Christian. If you believe that Jesus is not God, you're not a Christian. So what you believe about Genesis, your particular interpretation of Genesis or of Revelation, doesn't disqualify you, in my opinion. Okay. Thank you.